Hey, what's up, guys? Today I just wanted to do a really quick video and talk about a Chrome extension that I've been using for language learning recently. Now, if you don't know what Chrome extensions are, these are small little add-ons, little tools that you can add to your web browser in order to give you more functions on your web browser. And that's assuming that you're using the web browser Google Chrome, because if you're using Safari or Firefox or God forbid you're still using Internet Explorer, you need to get with 2018 because you are left behind in the last century. So anyways, the extension that I am talking about here is called Transpose Pitch Speed Loop. And it is an extension that I use a lot in order to affect the speed of my YouTube videos. Now, the main purpose that I use this is to slow down videos of people speaking foreign languages when they're speaking too quickly for me to understand. Now, there is a bit of an art to this because you do want to slow it down in order to be able to understand what they're saying better, but you don't want to slow the videos down too much or they'll become too distorted and you still won't be able to understand what they're saying. Now, let me show you this YouTube video here. We have Despacito. Most of you probably know this song. And they sing pretty fast. Here, I'll show you an example. So, one thing that you can do is use the built-in YouTube speed function, which is right here, and it's okay. It gives you a few different speeds that you can play your videos at, but it's very limited because it only gives you a few different increments to play your video at. What I do is I use this Chrome extension up here. I already downloaded it and I have it up here in my web browser in the upper right hand corner, and it has this little slider that allows you to change the speed of your video to whatever you want. You can speed it up really fast, you can slow it down really slow. For songs, I find a good speed to play it at is about 90%, and all you need to do is move this little slider and your video will automatically play at that speed. You can also fine tune it with little buttons up here. So now that I have it at 90%, let's play the song. And you can tell that the song is now a little bit slower, and you can probably hear a little bit of distortion in there because it's not playing at the speed it was designed to be played at. But it's not distorted too much where it makes the song unenjoyable to listen to. Let me slow it down a little bit further and show you what I'm talking about. We'll slow it down to about 50%. We'll do 55% and play it now. See, now it's not even enjoyable to listen to. It's not even a song anymore. It's just noise almost. So the trick is to find the right spot on this slider in order to listen to your songs, listen to your videos at the perfect speed that's gonna help you understand what you're listening to, but not destroy the quality of it. I recommend 90. You might be able to get away with a little bit lower than 90. Let's see here. But once you get much lower than 90, maybe 85, the quality of the song is gonna start to deteriorate. Fortunately, this extension is not only for songs. You can use it for regular spoken words. And here I have a comedian speaking in French. And so let's listen to him speak. C'est pour ça que si un jour je serai naufragé sur une île déserte, j'espère que cette île ne soit pas franche. Alright, and you can hear him speaking relatively quickly. Difficult for a non-native speaker of French to understand. So I'm going to slow him down not only to 90%, we'll slow him down to about 70%. Get that up to 70. Profond, parce que je sortirai jamais de cette île, parce que le mot help. And you can hear that even though it's still at 70%, it has been slowed down and it's been distorted a little bit. You can tell that it's not his actual normal voice. But it's not distorted so much that you can't understand what he's saying. As a matter of fact, it's slowed down just enough that it makes it easier to understand what he's saying than if you were playing it at the full 100% speed. In fact, we could probably even go in even slower. I bet you we could play this at 60% and still be able to understand what he's saying.
fois plus facile à créer dans le sable qu'au fucking secours.
So basically, the point that I'm trying to make here is you have to be able to find the right speed for you. So I definitely recommend playing around with different speeds and different settings and finding what's right for you. You could listen to the whole comedy skit at 60% and probably be able to understand quite a bit. It might be too slow, maybe you set it at 70, 75. You have to find the speed that is best for you for understanding whatever video you're listening to. Now, really quickly, if you've never used Google Chrome extensions before, this is a free extension, and basically what you're going to do is you're just going to go to Google or your search engine of choice, and you're going to type in Google Chrome extensions. And you're going to come to the Google Chrome Web Store. I'll also include a link to this extension in the description of this video. So if you don't want to do all the searching, you can just click on the link below. And once you get to the Google Chrome Web Store, you're going to type in, what was the name of it again? Transpose Pitch. All right, you're going to type in Transpose Pitch, and you can see it's the first one here. And this is the Chrome extension that you're looking for. It's going to have this logo. It's called Transpose Pitch Loop. You can see that I've actually already added it to my Google Chrome, so that's why it has this little green banner there. It's green. What you're probably going to see is this blue button, and it'll have a plus sign, and it'll say Add to Chrome. You're just going to click that. If you want more information about the add-on, you can just click on the box itself, and you'll see all the different details about the add-on. It's free, but there is a paid version of it. I don't use the paid version. I just use the free version, and it works just fine for me to do all the functions that I need it for. And once you add this to your Chrome browser, it'll show up here in the list of little add-ons. You just click on it, and then it'll give you all the settings, and that's all you need to know. So I hope this video has just given you one more little tool that you can use for learning your languages more efficiently. Thanks for watching the video, and we'll see you guys in the next one.